Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Welcome, brothers and sisters, to another episode in the series Gardens of the Righteous with myself and Sheikh Haytham Al Haddad. Sheikh Haytham is currently residing in the UK and is on the board of the Islamic Sharia Council of Britain and is also the founder of the website www.islam21c.com. Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
We have now come to the very last hadith in the first chapter of Riyad al-Salihin, which is on Ikhlas.
So let us read the last part of it.
Then the third supplicated, O Lord, I hired some laborers and paid them their dues, but one of them left, leaving behind what was due to him. I invested it in business, and the business prospered greatly. After a time, the laborer came back and said, O servant of Allah, hand over to me my wages. I said to him, all that you see is yours, camels, cattle, goat, and slaves. He said, don't play jokes with me, O servant of Allah. I assured him, I am not joking. So he took all of it, sparing nothing. Lord, if I did this seeking only your pleasure, do relieve us of our distress. The rock then moved away, and all the three came out of the cave, safe and sound.
Subhanallah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasulillah. We mentioned this hadith, a very great hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave us a story. And you know, stories affect people sometimes more than direct discussion or direct instructions. That's why the Quran is full of stories. Yeah? Surah Yusuf, the entire surah is a story. Surah Al-Qasas, it is called Surah Al-Qasas. The surah, the chapter of stories. Allah Jalla wa'ala commanded Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to narrate stories. فَقْصُصْ الْقَصَصَ. Narrate stories. وَكُلَّا نَقُصُ عَلَيْكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الرُّسُلِ. And we narrate to you the stories of previous prophets in order to make your heart upright. Anyway, so the Prophet ﷺ used to use this methodology in da'wah, the methodology of narrating stories. So he told the companions about this story, that there were three people from a previous nation. And those people, they were traveling, and then a storm hit them, or something hit them, so they need to go, or maybe they wanted to stay overnight inside a cave. So they entered inside the cave. After some time, a rock dropped to block the exit. So now they have no exit. Imagine the situation. If you have ever been in a cave and it was blocked, it is really a very scary situation.
Pitch black, no light.
Yes, I remember that, you know, we took a group of youngsters to go for, I don't know what they call it, the cave diving or somewhere in England, And you have to go with a person who has experience, and then you enter the cave, and the cave will go inside at one point, subhanallah, no light, and as if you are in a grave. You don't see each other except if you have the light, and it is very narrow, very tight. You don't know what will happen, what is in front of you. Very scary, very scary. So the cave was blocked. So they said, what shall we do? Let us ask Allah Jalla wa'ala, let us make dua to Allah Jalla wa'ala. So they started to make dua to Allah Jalla wa'ala, and this shows that at the end of the day, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, that at the end of the day, we need Allah Jalla wa'ala in the beginning of our matters, and we need Allah Jalla wa'ala in the end of our matters. We, without Allah Jalla wa'ala, are nothing. Without the help of Allah Jalla wa'ala, nothing. Wallahi, if we drink water, which is the source of life, water is what is the source of life. Without the guidance of Allah Jalla wa'ala, without the help of Allah Jalla wa'ala, this water will be a source of what? Of death. We cannot achieve anything without the help of Allah Jalla wa'ala. That's why, inshallah, we will discuss about dua and the importance of dua. In one of the chapters of this book is dua, one of the important chapters. Allah Jalla wa'ala says, أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُطَّرَّ إِذَا دَعَاهُ وَيَكْشِفُ السُّوءُ. أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُطَّرَّ. Who is going to answer the dua of the muttar? Who is going to help the person who is in a desperate situation?
No one except Allah.
Allah. Yes. Allah Jalla wa'ala said about some mushrikeen, وإذا ركبوا في الفلك دعوا الله مخلصين له الدين فلما نجاهم إلى البر إذا هم يشركون. When they go in the boat and then the storms and the sea is rough, yeah, then they will be afraid of what? Drowning into the sea. What are they going to do? They will realize that no one will help them except Allah. And Allah Jalla wa Ala mentioned this example in two or three places in the Quran as a challenge for the disbelievers, to tell them that, let me know who is going to help you in that situation.
Hmm.
As a challenge. And subhanAllah, as some people said that they have read the account of some of the atheists, those atheists who were in a plane, yeah? And the plane is about to crash. And then it was saved. The captain managed to save it. At that time, they said that the only thing we thought of is the Supreme Being to help us.
Mm.
They don't call Allah, Allah, okay? They don't call him a God. They say the Supreme Being, the Creator. And some of them, they say the God to help us. But you are atheists. You claim that there is no God. There is no God. No, God, believing in God is here. No one can deny believing in God is in our hearts.
From the fitrah as well.
From the fitrah, natural position. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, each born baby is born upon fitrah. Then his parents will make him a Jew or a Christian. And he didn't say they will make him a Muslim, because he is born on Islam. What is Islam? To submit to him. And Allah Jalla wa Ala says in the Quran, وَإِذَا أَخَذَ رَبُّكَ مِنْ بَنِي آدَمَ مِنْ ظُهُورِهِمْ ذُرِّيَّتَهُمْ وَأَشْهَدَهُمْ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ أَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ. This is the ayah of what? Of covenant. Yeah? In Surah Al-A'raf. And remember when Allah Jalla wa Ala took the children of Adam or the offspring of Adam from the reins of his back or from the reins of their backs. So the offspring, Allah Jalla wa Ala brought them out. Allah Jalla wa Ala is able to do anything. And then he told them, who am I? So he created them believing in Allah. They said, you are our Lord. He said, so on the day of resurrection, don't say, inna kunna an hada ghafilin. Don't say that you are heedless.
Mm.
Yeah? You were unaware of me as your creator. Yeah? So, the dua, subhanAllah, and the time of difficulty is in fact a mercy. Yeah? A mercy. How? Because of this difficulty, or Allah Jalla wa Ala is using this difficulty in order to remind you of Him, in order to push you to go back to Him, in order you think of Him. It is a mercy. So no one should think that, well, this is a punishment. From one angle, it is a punishment. But the punishment of Allah, this is the mercy of Allah. Even His punishment in the dunya is a mercy, either for the people who've been punished or the people who know about them or the people who see them.
SubhanAllah.
It is a mercy from all angles. And we had this story. We had this story. So, the three people, they started to make dua to Allah Jalla. And as we said, we will talk about importance of dua in the near future. The other point that is mentioned here, and the scholars mentioned it, is a technical point. Can we use wasila?
Mm.
Yeah? The issue of wasila. There is a big discussion about wasila. What is wasila? Wasila is to ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to do something for you using something. Ya Allah, because of this, help me. Ya Allah, I have done this, and because of this, help me. Ya Allah, yeah, part of the wasila, that it is a matter of discussion. Ya Allah, because of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, help me. Yeah? Or Ya Allah, because of this saint, or this righteous person, or this wali, or this great scholar, or this noble person, Ya Allah, because of him, help me. What is the ruling regarding that? Yeah? Is it allowed to do it? is not allowed to do it? What are the cases that we can do it? What are the cases that we can't do it? Okay, inshallah, we can continue the discussion after the break.
Brothers and sisters, please come back to us after the break. We shall continue this discussion with Sheikh Haitham Al-Haddad. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.